When paleoanthropologist Yohannes Haile-Selassie found a piece of lower jaw lying on the ground in the Middle Awash region of Ethiopia in 1997, he didn't realize that he had uncovered a new species. 11 specimens from at least 5 individuals later and from 5 localities in Ethiopia, he was convinced he had found a new early human ancestor. In 2002, 6 more teeth were discovered in the Middle Awash at the site Asa Koma and was finally confirmed to be fossils of a unique species and was named Ardipithecus kadabba, meaning the oldest ancestor in the Afar language. Ardi means ground or floor and is combined with the Latinized Greek word pithecus, meaning ape. The fossils found included hand and foot bones, partial arm bones, and a clavicle, and dates back to 5.8 to 5.2 million years ago. Ardipithecus kadabba was initially believed to be a subspecies of Ardipithecus ramidus, but the distinct features of the teeth found, especially the dental wear patterns, led the finders to place all the fossils into a new species rather than a subspecies. A toe fossil of this species also suggested that the individuals were bipedal. The foramen magnum, which is a large hole at the base of the skull, is located under the brain case, just as in a biped rather than a four-legged ape. With facial structures similar to that of apes, even their brain size was similar to the same. Ardipithecus kadabba had brain size measuring between 300 to 350 cubic centimeters. Some features of the teeth show a movement away from the primitive ape-like condition, such as molars that are larger than those of chimpanzees, but its front teeth are narrower, a tendency towards incisiform lower canines and hominin-like upper premolars. This evidence suggests this species did most of its chewing in the back of its mouth. This type of chewing would focus on hard-to-eat foods like fibrous nuts. Hence, we can say that instead of eating mostly fruit and soft leaves like chimpanzees, Ardipithecus kadabba ate a variety of fibrous foods. When it comes to the lifestyle, there is no evidence for any specific cultural attributes, but they may have used simple tools similar to those used by modern chimpanzees, including twigs, sticks, or even unmodified stone tools that may have been used for a variety of simple tasks, including obtaining food. Faunal evidence from the site indicate that the early humans there lived in a mixture of woodlands and grasslands and had plenty of access to water via lakes and springs, which also indicates the area was a mosaic of woodland and grasslands with lakes, swamps, and springs. The discovery that this species lived in a forest environment challenged the theory about what kind of environment fostered the evolution of bipedalism. With so little information, we are left with so many questions. Did bipedalism independently develop in the Ardipithecus lineage, or is Ardipithecus kadabba somehow related to Auroran tujanensis and Sahelanthropus tujanensis? How is the Ardipithecus lineage related to Australopithecus lineage? And how big were the average male and female individuals of this species? And was there a high level of sexual dimorphism in this early human species? We can only hope for answers. So with that, we have come to the end of the video. Thanks for watching, and do tell us what you thought of the video in the comments section down below. For related content, check out our channel, as we have made many just for you. And do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is HALABELLA, and see you soon in our next video.